Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's talk about substitution and elimination reactions, these four reactions that we will encounter with alkyl halides. So on the screen, it's kind of hidden, but in the middle here, this is our alkyl halide. In this case, it's a secondary halide. It's a secondary bromide. And this halide can undergo all four of these reactions. On the left, we have the substitution reactions. Remember that substitutions involve replacement of one functional group with another. In this case, it's not any functional group. We're replacing the halide with some other functional group, which is going to be some kind of nucleophile, and we'll define what the nucleophiles are. On the right-hand side of the screen, we have the elimination reactions. Eliminations make pi bonds. And so in these eliminations, we created a new carbon-carbon pi bond, and that happened in part through loss of the bromine. So in all these reactions, we're losing the bromine, we're losing the halide, and so that's why we refer to the halide as our leaving group in these reactions. So if you look on the right-hand side of the screen, the SN1 and SN2 both form the same product. That is not always the case, but it's certainly the case in these artificial examples I've given. For that reason, people often group the SN1 and the SN2, and they group together the E1 and the E2. I, however, take a different approach. And if you're learning organic chemistry from someone else and looking at these videos, you'll probably notice this. But I tend to aggregate the E2 and SN2 together because I think that they occur in the same reaction conditions. And the SN1 and E1 tend to have shared traits that make them convenient to group that way. So I don't think of the substitutions together. I think of the SN2 and the E2 together, as well as the SN1 and E1 together. Now, one final comment on style. We have these substitution reactions. The S stands for substitution. The N stands for nucleophilic. So we have a nucleophile that's replacing the halide. They are nucleophilic substitutions. The number stands for, and it's kind of a detail, it's the order of the reaction, the number of chemical species that come together in the rate determining step. Stylistically, SN2 and SN1 should be written this way. That's a capital S, a capital N that's subscripted, and then the number. It is not something like this, not SN, and so often we have numbers as subscripts. It's not that. Sometimes people will write lowercase n's and such. It's not that. Try to stick to this form. You'll see a lot of different styles on the internet, but the proper form, and I think communication in proper ways is important, is capital letter for the S, capital N, which is subscripted, and then the number. The same goes for elimination. That's a capital E and a number on the same line. It's not subscripted. So these are the substitutions and eliminations that we will encounter in this playlist on alkyl halides.